Hey everyone, this is Dr. Kazi, and in this video, we're going to learn about the blood supply of the pelvis. Now, there are various arteries involved in the blood supply to the pelvic walls. Some arteries are in relation with the pelvic brim, and some arteries are related to the pelvic cavity. Now, what is pelvic brim and the pelvic cavity? Have a look. The pelvic brim is this red dotted line which is extending from one hip bone to the other hip bone. It is a demarcation between the true pelvis and the false pelvis. The iliopectineal line of one hip bone will combine the iliopectineal line of the other hip bone to form the pelvic brim or the pelvic inlet. Above the pelvic inlet, you have the false pelvis, and below it, we have the true pelvis, which will contain the pelvic cavity. In other words, below the iliopectineal line or the pelvic inlet, we have the pelvic cavity. Now, we are going to trace the pathway of the nerves of the arteries involved in the blood supply. Have a look at this diagram. The descending aorta is continuing down in front of the vertebra and approximately at the level of fourth lumbar vertebra, this descending aorta will divide into two branches, the right common iliac artery and the left common iliac artery. This one, the right one and the left one. The right common iliac artery will cover a longer distance as comparison to the left one. And eventually, at the level of the pelvic brim or the pelvic inlet, it will divide into two branches, the external iliac, this one, and the internal iliac. Now, in this diagram, we're going to trace the pathway and the branches of external iliac artery, this one. It is continuing down and it is longer as comparison to the internal iliac artery, and eventually it will pass beneath the inguinal ligament, which is extending from the anterior superior iliac spine. And this external iliac artery will continue down as the femoral artery. Now, the femoral artery will supply the blood to the thigh region as well as the lower limb. Important branches of the external iliac arteries are femoral artery, the deep circumflex iliac artery, and the inferior epigastric artery. The inferior epigastric artery will ascend upward and it will supply the muscles of the anterior abdominal wall. The deep circumflex artery will ascend superiolaterally and it will supply the muscles contained in the iliac fossa, particularly the internal oblique muscle. Now, we are done with the external oblique. Let's talk about the internal oblique artery. Have a look at this diagram. The internal oblique artery has the anterior trunk and the posterior trunk. Have a look at the posterior trunk. It has three important branches, the lateral sacral artery, the superior gluteal artery, and the iliolumbar artery. The lateral sacral artery is descending in front of the sacral plexus, this one, and it will supply the structure present in the region. The superior gluteal artery is leaving the pelvis through this foramen, which is known as the greater sciatic foramen, and it will enter the gluteal region and supply the muscle of the gluteal region. The iliolumbar artery is ascending upward and it is crossing the pelvic brim, and it will supply two important muscles, the iliacus muscle and the psoas muscle. We're done with the posterior trunk. Now let's talk about the anterior trunk of the internal iliac artery. The anterior trunk has the following important branches: middle rectal artery, inferior vesical artery, inferior gluteal artery, and the internal pudendal artery. The middle rectal artery will anastomose with the superior rectal and the inferior rectal artery, and this middle rectal artery will supply the rectum of the large intestine. The inferior vesical artery, you have to remember this one, is only present in males, which will supply the prostate gland and the base of the bladder. But in case of female, you don't have the inferior vesical artery. It is replaced by the vaginal artery. The inferior gluteal artery will leave the pelvis, this whole cavity, along with the internal pudendal artery. These two arteries will leave the pelvis through the greater sciatic foramen and enter the gluteal region, supply the muscle of the gluteal region, and this one, the internal pudendal artery, also supply the anal canal. This was all about pelvis blood supply. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.